The Lords' debate was the last resort for the ILEA, hanging on by their fingernails at County Hall. They've been buoyed up by petitions of support from pupils, teachers and parents, and a parental ballot of 94% in favour of maintaining the authority. Even last night, the pressure was still being maintained, with critics of the government abolition plans linking hands around County Hall. But across the Thames, Mrs. Thatcher was preparing her troops, warning 170 Tory peers to support the government during the ILEA debate on the Education Reform Bill or face her displeasure. The Lords started their debate at 3 this afternoon, with amendments being sought to achieve a full independent review of the bill.
We must preserve some sense of balance and not allow policy to be dictated by the Evening Standard or the Daily Mail, or indeed by the flurry of pamphleteering to which most of us, I think, have been subjected in the last few days. Over the last year or so, there are distinct signs that ILEA has, none too soon, begun to put its house in order.
It's more than 7 years now since my noble friend Lord Carlisle demanded that the authority set its house in order. Since then, there have been reports, inquiries, and guidance galore. But in the classroom, which is what really matters, all too little has changed.
Those seeking the amendments, including the Bishop of Southwark, told the Lords that what they wanted was a panel of independent assessors, consulting all interested parties before deciding on ILEA's future. Mark Longhurst for Thames News.